If you have so much telemetry data that you're struggling to make sense of all the noise, or you just want to save on storage and egress costs, then you need to learn about sampling for OpenTelemetry. Sampling selectively captures a subset of data, but in a way that maintains statistical accuracy. With OpenTelemetry, sampling can be head-based, so before the data is collected, or tail-based, which samples only after collecting a set amount of data. Head-based is more efficient and can be done in code or after a piece of data is ingested by the OpenTelemetry collector. Tail-based allows for more informed sampling, but does require more resources since the OpenTelemetry collector needs to store all this data in memory before sampling. Even though OpenTelemetry supports sampling for both logs and traces, the trace sampling implementation is much more fleshed out than log sampling. Anyway, let's go through how to implement them both. This is a Go project that increments a counter and logs that value every single second. It uses the OTel slog bridge with a log processor and then exports the logs to the OTel collector using the with insecure option since we're doing this locally. If you want to know more about how and why the project is set up like this, then check out this video. The link for it should be in the description. Anyway, here is the configuration file for the OTel collector, and you can see it's just receiving the logs via OTLP and printing them out to the console. And if we look at the console, we can see the output of our logs. OpenTelemetry supports head-based log sampling with the OTel collector using the probabilistic sampling processor. The processor uses a randomized sampling technique, which can be set up like this with a sampling percentage of 10%. But of course, this value can be anything. Even 10.1. From here, we need to set an attribute source of record and a from attribute of value. The attribute source is where OpenTelemetry looks to find the from attribute. This could either be a record or a trace ID. And the from attribute tells OTel to sample or to choose randomness based on a specific attribute. In our case, we have an attribute in our logs called value, which is the value of the incremented number. With this new configuration, if we run our code, only 10.1% of our logs get sampled. You can add a hash seed option, which will hash the from attribute value or the trace ID using the fnv hash function. This means an attribute or trace ID is hashed based on the hash seed and selected based on a threshold instead of being sampled randomly. And if you have multiple OTel collectors, it's a good way to keep consistent sampling. If we update our code to include a tracer, a trace provider, a trace exporter, and then in our counter, create a trace span taking out the context and pass this context into our logger info, then our logs will have trace and span IDs, which means sampling will work with just a percentage since trace IDs are used as a default attribute source. While we're on the topic of traces, head-based trace sampling can happen in the trace provider using the withSampler option and passing in an argument like alwaysSample, which samples every trace, neverSample, which does the opposite. Parent-based, which only samples a span if its parent was sampled, and trace ID ratio-based, so a value of 0.5 will sample half of all the traces. Head-based sampling in the OTel collector using the probabilistic sampler is also supported with traces, but this only has two options, sampling percentage and mode. Sampling percentage, which we've already seen, and mode, which determines the type of sampling. There are three types of sampling modes. Proportional samples proportionally and doesn't consider how many times an item has already been sampled. Equalizing uses the same randomness as proportional, but considers how much an item has already been sampled. And because sampling data is stored in trace context, these considerations can be based on sampling made by different OTel collectors. There's also a hash mode, which uses a hash seed to ensure consistency between different collectors. Okay, that's enough about head-based sampling. Let's talk about tail-based. But before we do that, I mean, let's face it, looking at logs through the console is okay, but wouldn't it be nice if there was a really clean UI that allowed us to search and filter through logs? Well, this is where BetterStack comes in. BetterStack is a web-based tool that can ingest logs from a bunch of different sources and allows you to search through, filter, explore, and create metrics from logs, all with a really clean looking UI. But that's not all. BetterStack also gives you status pages, dashboards, alerts, uptime monitoring, on-call rotation, and much, much more, all with a really generous free tier. So go ahead and check out BetterStack today. And we're back talking about tail-based sampling, which is done with the tail sampling processor. At the moment, this is only supported for traces and not logs, and can be configured with the following options. The first being decision wait, which is the wait time in seconds since the first span before making a sampling decision. Num traces, the number of traces to keep in memory, please note the processor, will always make a decision on wait time, regardless of how many traces are in memory. Next is expected traces per second. This is to help with allocating data structures. Then we have the decision cache, which remembers sampling decisions for traces even after data has been removed from memory. This is useful if your num traces is low and you have a high amount of traces per second and you want to keep track of all the decisions that were made before traces are removed from memory to help you make decisions for new traces that come in. This has two fields, the sample cache size with number of trace IDs in the last recently used cache, and the non-cache sample size, which has a number representing the same thing. So these are the trace IDs that were sampled, and these are the trace IDs that were dropped. Then there's policies, which is not an option, since you need at least one of these for the tail sampling to work. And a policy is what is used to make a sampling decision. You can set a policy based on latency, status code, rate limiting, a string attribute, a numeric attribute, or even a Boolean attribute. You can even create sub-policies or create policies using the OpenTelemetry transformation language. In fact, let's go ahead and write our own policy. If we change our counter code to trigger an error record and an error log each time a counter value is divisible by 5, we could write a policy that only samples for errors based on status code, which we can see works because only the errors are being shown in the console. But it's helpful to have more context around the data and not just an error message, so that you can see what might have caused the error. So we can add a probabilistic policy with a sampling percentage of 10%. And this will show some of the other spans as well as the error spans. Remember, because tail-based sampling stores data in memory, it may make sense to use the memory limiter processor in the OTel collector to limit the amount of memory that is used. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this run through of sampling with OpenTelemetry. If you want to know more about, say, policies or anything else, then check out the links in the description. I've added a load of documentation. And if you enjoyed this content and want more like it, then be sure to subscribe.